The joint is just jumping today because Cake is here. Two of the quintet have managed to sit down to engage in a conversation. John McRae, he's the lead singer and songwriter, and trumpet player Vince DiFiore. Is that how you say your last name?
Yeah, thank you. That's good pronunciation.
Is it?
Yeah, it's excellent.
What,
yeah.
Is that what you call yourself?
I would say DiFiore.
That's good then. We're right on the same track.
Right. Those vowels are squirrely in Italian, though.
Well, you pronounce everything, don't you, in Italian? Everything that's there, you say it.
I think so.
Do you speak Italian?
A little bit, you know, not so much. I speak English mostly from California.
Well, with being from California and all. Yeah. So that, I think it's a great honor that you've worn a toque today.
Right, I am, in honor of being in Canada. Yeah.
Is that true? No, you just always
sort
wear
of.
One?
And messy hair and being in Canada and the word toque being so great. Because
it,
we don't
it
hear
is
that
a good
in
word,
the
isn't
States
it?
Very
good,
much.
Good onomatopoeic word, isn't it?
You mean
toque sounds like. This sounds like a toque, you know.
Yeah.
Looks like it sounds.
Oh, they're so entranced with us quaint little Canadians, aren't they? And you, on the other hand, look like you just came off an aircraft carrier.
Well, you know, I work for a living, you know, and wearing work clothes makes me feel comfortable. Mm. You know? I couldn't imagine wearing sequins.
No.
You know.
No, but you are an entertainer.
Yeah, but our music is sort of a matte finish. Kind of music.
Not all glossy.
No, not really. We're comfortable that way.
Yeah, well, I think that's fair enough. But the hat and the aviator glasses and that sort of thing, it's a look.
Yeah, and it's sort of standing a little bit back, which I'm comfortable with.
As a professional musician?
Yeah, I mean, I'm providing a music service rather than sort of shoving my face in front of everyone.
Right,
I feel good about
that. It's about what you produce, not you.
Yeah, right, exactly.
So what happens if you all become zillionaires and on the front page of every magazine and are on Letterman, actually on Letterman three times. They've been denied access to Mr. Letterman, either flown in, canceled something or other, but I think next time, lucky.
Maybe so. They're telling us the 13th, so maybe we'll be on the 13th.
Well, we were trying to devise some sort of way to guarantee it, that is, you know, some just, you know, begging, I think, is
right,
would be good.
Right, or publicity stunt out in the street if we don't get on. Or
yeah, lying down and kicking.
Yeah,
that'd be very mature. the song that you're going to sing later on, Love You Madly, from the new album, the video is the strangest video I have ever seen in my entire life and one of the funniest.
Thanks. Yeah.
Would you like to we're going to show a clip of it, but I think you should just set the scene.
Well, you know, Vince is actually a very good cook, and so is our drummer, Pete, who's in the other room. And they talk about food all the time, which is sort of frustrating on tour because you're at the mercy of a truck stop. Yeah, or whatever, you know. And they talk about, you know, sauteing mushrooms and stuff. And, you know, it's sort of irritating. So I thought.
Makes for good conversation.
It sort of does, but it's also, it's sort of frustrating. And so I thought, well, we need to make a video for our next single, and we could either do, you know, a video where there's five white guys lip syncing in an Urban Decay setting.
Yeah, that'd be original.
Yeah. Or we could try to just completely throw that away, and I could pit Vince against Pete with celebrity judges in a cooking competition. And
you're looking
for real.
Your expression on your face is like you're hearing this for the first time.
Yeah, I know. I'm still nervous before I do
it. It was a really stressful situation that I put them in. It was an actual cooking competition between the two
like
of them.
Like Iron Chef, sort of.
Yeah, exactly.
Without the capes, though. I wanted you to come out with the cape. Yeah,
we didn't have that budget.
Oh, yeah. I could have loaned you a cape for nothing.
Yeah.
We needed you to bite into a yellow bell pepper or something.
Yeah, exactly.
Like that.
Oh, it would have been good. Yeah. And they had judges.
Yeah. Yeah, we had Rick James and
Phyllis Diller and the Frugal Gourmet.
That's right, Jeff Smith, yeah.
Okay, well, I think that we'll should take a look at this. I think it's the funniest video out for ever.
I want to love you madly. I want to love you now. I want to love you madly. Away. I want to love you madly.
I'm telling you, Phyllis Diller, she must be she's a certain age, that girl.
Yeah, she's pretty old, but she's really professional and she still looks really good. She's really aware of, you know, camera angles and she's aware of like people not stepping on each other's lines. She's very professional.
Yeah, and she looks amazing.
She looks great. She was funny, too.
And I want her surgeon, and I want him here now.
Yeah, so do I.
And who won?
Well,
we can't tell you, can we? Can we tell?
I don't know.
Okay, we'll tell.
You didn't, obviously, because you're signing whiny.
Yeah, I know, exactly. I made some string beans, and I overcooked them, and I didn't want to serve that to the celebrity judges, so I threw some raw snap peas.
Yes.
I'd been snacking on. I thought they were delicious. But
they
were
raw. They didn't like the raw feature.
They did not like that.
Phyllis Diller particularly was pissed off.
They just took me down.
Yeah. She was pissed off about the snap peas.
Yeah, she was pissed. She's like, she goes, she made this face like, you know, just like, this is so wrong. She gave him an 8 or something instead of.
Oh, it was more of a garnish. I got taken down by the garnish.
30 seconds ago, we loved her. Now.
No, no, we like her. I think
we
admire
her to do that.
We appreciate her candor. You know, I mean, she wasn't BSing anyone.
We had to have a winner.
You guys actually went to school and everything, don't you? You can put sentences together. It's frightening. Your other video.
The same sort of deal. We were frightened of making a music video, and we were trying to find ways of avoiding it.
And you have.
Yeah, and we thought, well, people are more interesting and more varied in their experiences than celebrities and musicians. So turn the camera around and maybe it becomes a wider sort of array of possibilities.
You put headsets on people in different locations.
Yeah.
Like Toronto and Vancouver.
Yeah.
And then Mexico.
Mm-hmm.
Where else?
In San Francisco and Sacramento and New York City. And do we say New York? Yeah. So, I mean, that's about it.
And who liked you the best, did you find? The children seemed happy.
Children and old people, actually. Yeah. Yeah, because they're less concerned about using music as a badge. They're just going for visceral enjoyment.
I like the guy. There's one moment where this sort of suit guy is standing on a step, and he says, I need someone to dance with. And so he starts dancing with the railing.
Right.
I love that. It was a great moment, I have to say. You, trumpet player, I love a horn section, but you're all alone.
Yeah, I am. Yeah, it's sad.
A lot of Mexican bands have just one trumpet, you know, and they feel lonely, too. I mean,
Even Herb Alpert.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah. Do you like Herb Alpert?
I do like Herb Alpert, yeah. My parents had some of his records.
I'll bet
they
did, yeah.
So maybe I've gleaned a little bit of his.
Who do you
tone.
Like as a horn player?
Clifford Brown is my favorite, yeah. And sure, I like Miles Davis and Dizzy Gillespie a lot. And
well, you have good taste.
I used to watch Doc Severinsen a lot as a kid on the television. Any trumpet player who has a name is usually pretty great.
Yes, good because, to listen to. Because you don't get too far if you can't play. If you're a trumpet player.
Yeah, it's
you know,
true.
You can fake it if you're. And this is no reflection on your bass player, who's a fine bass player. But if you could, manage, you can stand in the back and play some instruments. Trump. I wish I'd never said that. I'm not leaving this room.
No, he's a good bass player. But it's just trumpet is more like walking the plank.
It is.
You're going out on a limb, and that's something that we're aware of. And bass is something that can be a little bit more changeable, and people don't notice it.
And your guitar seems to be held together with, sealing
with
wax
tape.
And tape.
It actually split in half in front of 16,000 people on stage one time. We were doing this big
concert.
Could we
get a new one?
No, because I can't find a new one. I'm looking for another guitar just like it, and I haven't been able to find one.
What kind is it?
It's really a cheap guitar. Well, it's not really cheap, but it's just sort of medium expense guitar from the 60s. It's called a Goya.
Right.
And it's because it's not sought after, it's so hard to find. You know.
And you need the same kind.
Yeah, I do. It has this sort of cheap array of frequencies that fits into the sound of the band. Because no one else would want those frequencies, really.
Kenneth, what is the frequency?
Sort of.
We never knew found out what that meant.
What does it mean?
Who knows? Don't you? You're too young. You don't remember this. I can't stand it. Dan Rather, when he was accosted by some guy on the street, and somebody came up to him and thumped him and said, Kenneth, what is the frequency?
Oh, my God,
All he had to say was, like, 91.2.
Yeah, and the guy would have gone away, but it's become a legend.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Well, you see?
I don't get out much.
No, apparently not. Sure. Anyway, nice to meet you. I'm glad you came out enough to come to Vancouver. See you again.
Okay, thank you.